We have completed displaying dynamic data from the cart. Now in this section, what we are going to do, we are going to work on updating the quantity. Here we have this input field. Let me just update to 15. As soon as I click on update button, this value has to be stored inside this quantity field. So to update any data, first we have to wrap this inside one form. I will come. Now this is our table data inside which we are having one container. Inside this we have input field as well as we have this quantity button. So first step, what we have to do, this entire thing we have to wrap inside one form. So using post method, we can send the data inside the database. I will come. I will write form. Action, I am not going to give anything, but I will write here method. Method will be post. This closing form I will copy from here, cut it, and below this div I am just going to wrap. Now this will be treated as one form. Inside this form I am having div container. Inside that div container I have one input field and I have one button. Now while updating the quantity, which quantity I have to update? The ID which is present inside the database, this one, this is unique for every product, ID 1, ID 4. So whenever I click on this, whenever I click on this update button, only for this ID, the data has to be updated inside the database. So below this form, I will be creating one input field of type hidden. This input field will not be visible in project because we have given the type as hidden. For this, I'm just going to write the value. I will copy this. I just want to display the ID. Copy. Copy entire PHP. And inside this, I'm just going to paste. I will just write here ID. So using this fetch cart products and using this ID name, I am just going to fetch the ID of that particular product. Suppose laptop is displayed, for laptop I am having the ID as 1, 1 will be fetched. Suppose I want to display headphone, for headphone ID will be 4, so 4 will be fetched. But here using this num, for every time we are updating numbers in proper series, but using this ID, we will fetch the ID present inside the database. And I have given the type as hidden so that this input field will not be visible in our project. So once form is created, once we have passed the method attribute, and once we have created our input hidden field, next step is passing the most important attribute, that is name attribute. Here for this input hidden field, I will just write here name. Inside this, I'm just going to give update quantity ID. This attribute is very important. Without this attribute, we won't be able to write any query. Now for this input field, I'm going to give name attribute. Name is equal to update quantity. And finally for this button, because whenever I click on this button, only then the quantity should be updated. Name attribute. And for this button, I will just write here update cart quantity. Update cart quantity. Or I will write here update product quantity. Save this. I will come. I will refresh my project. As soon as I refresh this, one data which is present below, that is headphone, that is deleted. Basically, that is removed from here. I will come to my code. Now here, I just have to write double quotes. Save this. If there is some error, then our data will not be displayed. Now our headphone data we have received. Now we are going to write PHP. I will copy this name attribute. I will come on top, and here we are going to write update query. Update query. Previously also we have seen how to write update query. Now for this cart, I am going to show you step by step, because this kind of cart will be useful in every project. I will write if is set. Inside this I am going to pass this post method, and I will pass this variable name, that is our name attribute value. So what I am telling, if this is set, when I click on this button, only then whatever query I write, that has to be executed. I will just write here update, update value. Inside this, I am just going to fetch my input field, post is equal to, for this input field, I have given this one, I will copy, I am going to paste. I will just write here echo update value, save this. I will come, I will refresh this one. Okay, I got this error on line 3. So here what I have done, I have just started my query here. I will remove this closing bracket and I will be closing it here. Save this. I will refresh this one. I will just update to 3. I will just update it to 5. Click on update. Now you can see 5 is displayed. So whatever update value I am having, I am able to fetch that one. I will comment it out. Now below this, I am just going to fetch this product ID. I will come. This is the name we have given. Copy this. I will just create one variable. I will just write here update ID is equal to $post, and inside this I am going to pass that name. Here also I am just going to display this one, date ID. Save this. I will refresh this one. Now when I click on this update, ID is 1, so 1 will be displayed. Now when I click on this update button, ID is 4, so 4 will be displayed. Using this update quantity, we are able to fetch the value from the input field, and using this update quantity ID, we are able to fetch the ID number from the table. I will comment it out. This both data are required to write our query. I will just write one comment, query. Below this, I will be creating one variable. Update quantity is equal to, or you can write update quantity query, whatever you want you can write, is equal to MySQLi query, and inside this I am going to pass this connection variable, and then we are going to write our query. Update, what I want to update, I want to update cart table. Update table name, this is the syntax for update query. Update table name, set keyword, what I have to update, I have to update quantity with this value. I will copy this from this input value, I just have to update. Where my database ID, if this ID is equal to this ID, as soon as I click on update button, the ID which I received, that ID is equal to database ID, only then I have to update that particular row. So this is the simple query. Date, table name, set, quantity, I will change the spelling, later on we will get the error then. Quantity is equal to this update value, where our database ID is equal to this update ID. Only then we are going to update this one. If we don't give this where condition, then all the rows will be updated with this value. So we are just giving this where condition. I will save this. I will come. Oh, let me just write one echo. Echo updated successfully. Save this. I will refresh this one. I will give here to click on update. Updated successfully. I will come. Now you can see I am having the quantity as 1. As soon as I refresh, the quantity should be updated to 2. You can see quantity is updated to 2. Now for this headphone, I am just going to give the quantity as 6. Update. Updated successfully. I will come. I will refresh this one. Now the quantity is 6. And here also, the number which I am having inside the database, that quantity will be displayed inside this input field. So what I want to do, I do not want to refresh it again. Instead, I am just going to write, if my update query is successful, I will copy this. I am going to paste. If this is successful, as soon as I click on update button, directly I just want to redirect it to cart page. I will just write, that is same page location, and inside this I'm going to write cart.php. Save this. I will come again. I will refresh. Now quantity I'm just going to decrease to 4. Date, directly I'm inside cart.php and quantity is updated to 4. Now inside my table, quantity will be updated to 4. Okay, this is the simple process. First step, what we have done, we have just wrapped our entire thing inside one form. For this, we have given the method attribute. We have created one input hidden field so that we can fetch the ID from the database. Then for both this input field, we have given the most important attribute, that is name attribute. So inside query, if our button is set, only then we are fetching the value from the input field and we are fetching the ID from the database. Then we are just updating our quantity column with this update value which we have given in input field. For which value we are updating? If the database ID is matching with this input field ID, only then we are updating this one. Suppose if I don't give this condition, save this, I will come, I will refresh this one. Now I will give here 3. Click on update. You can see both the inputs field will be updated to 3. I will refresh this one. Both, how many rows, doesn't matter if you are having 100 rows or 1000 rows, all the rows quantity will be updated to 3. So it is very important to give this where condition. If you are working in bigger project and if you change entire data, then you will be mess up with entire code. So where condition is very important to update only that particular row. So once our query is successful, we are redirected to same page, that is cart.php. We are done with our updating part. Next, we are going to display the total price.